हेलो एवरीवन, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट चैप्टर ऑफ योर एनसीईआरटी एक्सरसाइज व्हिच इज लाइन एंड एंगल्स। डियर स्टूडेंट, इन प्रीवियस क्लासेस वी ऑलरेडी डिस्कस सम इंपॉर्टेंट कॉन्सेप्ट रिगार्डिंग टू चैप्टर ऑफ लाइंस एंड एंगल्स। ओके, नाउ टुडे वी आर ऑल्सो डिस्कस सम इंपॉर्टेंट कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ चैप्टर लाइन एंड एंगल्स। एंड डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वी टेक एंड सॉल्व some important questions based on them. Okay, so now let's see some important concept related to lines and angle, then after that we take and solve some important questions of your NCERT exercise based on line and angles. Let's see. Dear students, you know that if there are two points A and B, if we draw simply that, so this is called the line segment. This is a line segment has two end points. A line segment has two end points. Here AB is your line segment, and representation of that is in this way. Dear student, we represent the any line segment in this way, that is AB. Okay, now if that line segment AB extend in one direction, that B extend in one direction and it is indicated as by an arrow, then this is called a ray. This is called what? Ray, and it is denoted by in this way. This is the ray AB is denoted by AB in this way. This is the representation of ray. Okay, now if dear student, if any line segment extended in both the direction in this way, if any line segment extends in both the direction, then it is said to be a line. So and the line AB denoted by in this way. This is the representation of line. Okay, so this is the concept of line. Now we discuss some important concept regarding to angle. Now let's see. Suppose that there is students. Suppose we draw a ray OA. Okay, and if dear students, if we rotate that ray in anti-clockwise direction. In this way, suppose that ray rotate in anti-clockwise direction, and its final position is what? B. Okay, then that ray subtend make an angle AOB. Then that rotation of ray OA to B, that is called an angle. Okay. So this is the concept of angle. This is very important for you and your exercise. Okay, chapter line and angle. So dear student, now we discuss some important concept related to line and angles. Now dear student, we discuss some different types of angles formed by a line. Now suppose dear students, Now first of all we discuss about the adjacent angle. Now what is the concept of adjacent angles? Dear students, this is the very important concept of you and your chapter. Now we discuss about the, what is the concept of adjacent angle. Dear students, two angles, there are three important necessary conditions for adjacent angles. This is if two angles. Suppose that we form a ray OA, OB, and third ray OC. Suppose that here we form three rays OA, OB, and OC. Okay. Dear students, here angle AOC and angle BOC. Here two angles formed by these rays. Here one angle AOC and angle BOC. Okay, dear students, these angles are said to be adjacent angles. If and only if they have the common vertex O. Okay, this is the condition for adjacent angles. Dear students, two angles is said to be adjacent angles if they have the common vertex O. Okay, and they have all common arms. Here the common arms is OC, and the non-common arms here in the diagram given in that figure, the non-common arms is OA and OB. Okay, the non-common arms are either side of the common arms. Dear student, this is the condition for adjacent angles. Here we angle AOC and angle BOC are said to be adjacent angle. If क्यों? Because of they have the common vertex O, okay, and they have the common arm OC, and their non-common arms means OA and OB. Their non-common arms are either side of the common arm. So this is the condition, dear student, for the adjacent angles. So this is one of the most important concept of the chapter line and angles. Now we discuss some other important concepts regarding that chapter. Now dear students, we discuss about the concept linear pair. Now let's see, we discuss about the concept linear pairs. Look dear students, now here we discuss about the concept linear pair. Let's see the concept of linear pair. Suppose that OA, OB and third leg OC. Dear students, two adjacent angles, two adjacent angles are said to be linear pairs, if and only if they have the common vertex, this clear, they have the common arms OC, because of angle AOC and angle BOC, both angles have the common arm OC, okay, and the third condition is very important for linear pairs, the non-common arms are opposite rays, here should the non-common arms is what, OA and OB, na? In that figure, their non-common arms are OA and OB, which are opposite rays, so they form a linear pair. So we can say that here angle AOB and angle BOC, are what? Are opposite rays. So this is the very important concept related to that topic. Okay, and one important thing is that the sum of linear pairs is also 180 degree, and okay, the linear pairs means angle AOB plus angle BOC, angle BOC equal to what? 180 degree. This is the very important concept of linear pairs. Okay dear students, two angles are said to be linear pairs if they have the common vertex O, they have the common arm that is OC, and the non-common arm are opposite rays. So dear students, this is the concept of linear pair. This is one of the most important concept of that chapter. So it is now just it is clear. Now we discuss some other important concept related to that chapter. Let's see. Now dear students, we discuss about the concept of vertically opposite angle. Let's see. Here, if two lines, here suppose that AB and CD. Dear students, suppose that here AB and CDs are two lines which are intersect at point O. Suppose that here two lines AB and CD intersect at point O, then the pair of angles AOC and angle BOD have angle AOC and angle BOD. Angle BOD are from the pair of opposite, vertically opposite angles, as well as angle AOD and angle BOC. Angle BOC also form a pair of vertically opposite angles. These are the what? Vertically opposite angles. Okay, so dear students, these are the vertically opposite angles. And one important result related to that means vertically opposite angles are also always equal to each other. Dear students, vertically opposite angles always equal to each other. So this is the very important concept related to that chapter. Okay, now dear students, now we discuss some other important concept related to that chapter. This is now we discuss about the transversal angle made by the transversal. Let's see. Now, dear friends, we discuss about the angles formed by transversal. We discuss about the angle formed by the transversal. Dear friends, what is the concept of transversal? In previous classes, when we revise the chapter lines and angles, then I discuss about that topic always. Also means angles formed by the transversal. Okay, dear friends, if there are two lines, suppose that AB and CD. Suppose that, dear friends, here if there are two lines AB and CD which are parallel to each other, and a line T, and these lines cut by our transversal T, and the third line in this way, then that line is said to be the transversal. Here, dear students, here two lines AB and CD which are parallel to each other and cut by the transversal T. Then angle formed by these lines, these transversal is there. Let's see. Suppose this is 1, this is 2, this is 3, this is 4, this is 5, this is 6, 7 and 8. Dear students, here some important angles formed by these transversal in that figure named as, first of all we discuss about the corresponding angles. Dear students, first we discuss about corresponding angles. Dear students, there are four pairs of corresponding angles in that figure. This is angle 1, angle 5, angle 2, angle 6, angle 2, angle 6, angle 3, angle 7, and angle 4, angle 8. Dear students, here there are four pairs of corresponding angles are there, which is made by the transversal T. Here angle 1, here the pair of our corresponding angles are 1, 5, 2, 6, 3, 7, 4, 8. And according to very important theorem, the corresponding angles are equal to each other. Means says that angle 1 is equal to angle 5, angle 2 is equal to angle 6, okay, angle 3 is equal to angle 7, and angle 4 is equal to angle 8. Dear students, so we can say that if two parallel lines cut by the transversal T, then the pair of corresponding angles are always equal to each other. So this is the very important concept. Now, second one is what? Very important. This is alternate interior angle. Now, alternate interior angles. Dear students, what is the concept of alternate interior angle? Let's see here. In the given, suppose that AB and CD are two parallel lines and cut by the transversal T, then the pair of alternate interior angles are, pair of alternate interior angles are what? Angle 3, angle 5, and angle 4, angle 6. Angle 4, angle 6. Dear students, if two parallel lines cut by the transversal T, then there are only two pairs of alternate interior angles are, which are angle 3, angle 5, angle 4, angle 6. And according to very important result, when two parallel lines cut by the transversal T, then the pair of alternate interior angles are also equal to each other. Means that angle 3 is equal to angle 5 and angle 4 is equal to angle 6. Because of these are the pairs of alternate interior angles. Okay, so and we can say that the pair of alternate interior angles are also always equal to each other. Now that is clear. Now second types of angles which are made formed by the transversal is consecutive interior angle, which are also very important concern. The angle consecutive interior angles. Okay, consecutive interior angle. Dear students, in that figure, here two parallel lines ABCD cut by the transversal T, then the pair of consecutive interior angles are angle 4, angle 5, angle 3, and angle 6. So thus, dear students, in this way we can say that if two parallel lines cut by the transversal T, then there are only two pairs. There are only two pairs of consecutive interior angle, which are angle 4, angle 5, and angle 3, and angle 6, which are very important for you and your examination purpose. So these are the very important angle 4, angle 5, and according to a very important result related to consecutive interior angles are ki the pair of consecutive interior angle, the pair of consecutive interior angles are supplementary to each other. Supplementary means that what? The sum of their measures is 180. Means angle 4 plus angle 5 is equal to 180 degree, as well as angle 3 plus angle 6 also equal to 180, because of these are the pair of consecutive interior angles, and according to a very important result, the pair of consecutive interior angles are supplementary to each other. Now in this way, dear students, we discuss all the important concept related to line and angles, and also we discuss all types of angle made by the lines. Now dear students, we take and solve some important questions based on these topics which are discussed in that class. Let's see. Now we take some question, important question based on these topics which are discussed in that class. Dear students, let's see. Your first question is, in the given figure, lines xy and mn intersect at O if angle POY is equal to 90 degree, POY and A is to B, and A ratio B is equal to 2:3, find the value of C. And your figure is that. Let's see. Your figure is that these are XY, line XY, and here line MN. This is MN, intersect at point O, and angle that is POY is a 90 degree, okay, and this is angle A, this is angle B, and this is angle C. We find the angle C, okay. Yes, this is the figure which is very important question of for you and your examination purpose. Let's see. Here dear students, in the given figure, lines XY and MN, okay, lines XY and MN intersect at point O, and angle POY, angle POY is what? 90 degree, and the ratio of angle A and B is what? 2:3, okay, and we find angle C. Now let's see its solution. First of all, dear students, here since A is to B is equal to 2:3, na, so let A is equal to what? 2x and B is equal to 3x respectively, okay. Now in that question, dear students, first of all we let A is equal to 2x, okay, A is equal to 2x and B is equal to what? 3x respectively. Now then from figure, the sum of all that angles, angle A plus angle B, from figure A plus B plus angle POY, each the sum of these angles is 180, because of we know that the sum of angle on a straight line is 180. So here that is 180. Now we put angle A is equal to what? 2x plus angle B is equal to what? 3x plus angle POY is what? Angle POY is what? 90 degree. So right, put 90 is equal to 180. That is angle 3 to 5x is equal to 180 minus 90. That is 5x is equal to what? 90.
So the value of x is equal to 90 upon 5, and which is equal to what? 18. Thus, the value of x is equal to 18 degree. Thus, in this way, we find the value of x. Now, the value of a and b is what? Let's see. Thus, value of a. The value of a is equal to 2x. So, value of 2 into x is what? 18. Mean 18 to the 36 degree. The value of a is 36. And the value of b. The value of b is what? And the value of b is what? 3x. So 3 into the value of x. X is what? 18. 18 is a 54 degree. So the value of a is 36 and the value of b is 54 degree. Now what we find? Yes, we find the value of c. Now let's see. MN is a straight line. Now let's see, dear students. Now MN is a what? Straight line, na? MN is what? MN is a straight line. That is what we have? Angle B plus angle C. B plus C is equal to what? 180 degrees. Because of the sum of angle B plus angle C, these angles may form on the straight line MN, and so their sum of measure is what? 180 degrees. So 180. So now we put the value of B. The value of B is what? 54. Here we put 54 plus C is equal to 180. Thus the value of C is 180 minus 54. Now we subtract them. 180 minus 54. We get what? Let's see. 6 to 126. Thus the value of C is 126 degree. This is our required answer. Thus in this way we get the value of A, B and C. So thus the student, in this way you can solve each and every questions of your NCERT exercise based on these topics. Now we take and solve some more important question based on line and angles in this. Let's see. Now we take some other question, one very important question of your NCERT exercise. Let's see, dear students. Find the values of x and y and show that your question is find the values of x and y and show that AB parallel to CD. AB parallel to CD. Okay, and your figure is what? Let's see. Here two lines parallel. AB and CD here. Okay, and cuts by in this way. Suppose that, and this is 50 degree. This is X. Okay. And this is y, and this is 130 degree. Dear friends, this is the question here. In that question, what we do? Let's see. Here, find the values of x and y and show that AB parallel to CD. Dear friends, in finding the value of x and y, let's see. From figure, it is clear that is the straight line, the angle formed. You know the angle formed on a straight line is 180. Now let's see its solution. Angle on a straight line is what? 180. Now from figure, yani x plus 50 is equal to what? 180. Now here the value of x is equal to 180 minus 50. Thus the value of x is equal to 130 degree. In this way we get the value of x. This is one answer. In this way we get the value of x, na? Similarly, let look here. These are the pair of vertically opposite angles, na? Now again from figure y is equal to 130 degree because of y, since vertically opposite angles are equal to each other, since vertically opposite angles are equal to each other. So these are the some basic concepts of that questions. Now in this way we find the value of x as well as we find the value of y. Now what I do, yes friends, and also we have to show that AB parallel to CD. Now also we have to show that AB parallel to CD. Now again from figure, let's see. Here x and y both are equal to 180. From since angle x is equal to angle y, we have the each equal to 130 degree and which are equal to 130 each. And when vertically opposite angles are equal to each other, na, these are the alternate interior angles. These are what? Alternate interior angles. If yes, sir, you know that if two lines, alternate interior angles are equal to each other, if and only if AB parallel to CD cuts by the transversal that. Thus AB parallel to CD. Hence proof. In this way, lesson we proved that key lines AB parallel to line CD because of here the alternate interior angles are equal to each other. Okay. Now, lesson in this way you can solve each and every questions of your NCERT exercise based on these topics. Okay. Now let's see one more question based on these topics. Now find the value of x and y, and your figure is that. Let's see. Here AB and CD are two parallel lines. AB and CD are two parallel lines, and a triangle here PQR is formed. And in that figure, that is 50, that is x, that is y, and that is 127. Reason, these are, this is the question. This is very easy question. Let's see here. Let's see, since AB parallel to CD, na, and we take PQ as is a transversal. Then what I get? Then x is equal to 50 degree because of y. Because of these are the alternate interior angles. And alternate interior angles are equal to each other since x is equal to 50 degree. See, now angle PRQ, angle PRQ is what? 180 minus 127, because of the angle formed on a straight line is 180 degree, na? So these subtract them, we get what? Let's see. 180 and 27 subtract them, 10 minus 7, that is 3. And here 7 is left, 10 minus 2, that is 5. So 53. Now we apply the angle sum property. Now in triangle PQR, x plus y plus 53 is equal to what? 180 degree. And here now we put the value of x is what? The value of x is 50 plus we find the value of y, and here 53 is equal to 180. Now we have y plus 35510 is equal to 180. Now the value of y is what? 180 minus 103 is equal to what? We subtract 103 from 180. So 180 minus 103 minus 10 minus 3, that is 7. That is 7. Okay, 77 degree. This is another answer. And this is the value of x is this. Thus, there is friends, in this way you can solve each and every questions of your NCERT exercise based on line and angles. Now, dear students, today we discuss all the important concept related to line and angles, and we discuss all types of topic which are involved in your chapters. Now,
you practice that question which we discussed in that class. Now after that you can solve each and every questions of your NCERT exercise. Okay, now in next class we take and revise some other chapter of your NCERT exercise. Thank you dear students.